हेलो फ्रेंड्स एंड वेलकम बैक। टुडे वी आर परफॉर्मिंग एक्सपेरिमेंट ऑन KCL। KCL स्टैंड्स फॉर किरचॉफ्स करंट लॉ। सो इन दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट वी विल वेरीफाई द KCL बाय यूजिंग दिस टी टाइप नेटवर्क। सो हियर यू कैन फाइंड वी आर हैविंग थ्री रेजिस्टेंसेस R1, R2 एंड R3 एंड करंट फ्लोइंग थ्रू देम वी आर कॉलिंग एज I1, I2 एंड I3 रिस्पेक्टिवली। एंड फ्रॉम दिस साइड वी आर अप्लाइंग 10 वोल्ट। ओके, सो दिस इज योर सप्लाई वोल्टेज and these are the resistance values. We have already measured those resistance values by using ohm meter. Okay, KCL states that algebraic sum of all incoming current is equal to algebraic sum of all outgoing currents at any node. So far as our circuit is concerned, we are having node. Okay, so at this node we are applying KCL. So what are the incoming currents? I1 is incoming current and I2 and I3 are outgoing currents. So as per the statement of KCL, what we are getting? I1 means incoming current is equal to outgoing current I2 plus I3. Okay, so we have to measure I1, I2 and I3. So for this experiment, we are using this experimental setup. Okay, so you are already acquainted with this experimental setup. I have performed number of experiments by using this experimental board. The links are available in description. Okay, so here you can find that we are having this T-type network. Okay, R1, R2 and R3 we are using. In order to measure current flowing through these resistors, we are using I1, I2 and I3. So these are the connectors where we are externally connecting ammeters. And in this we are having two loops. So at a time we can apply two voltages. Okay, but as per our circuit diagram, we need only one voltage source. And from the back side, you can see that we have already soldered desired value of resistances. Okay. So this is about this experimental board. And now in order to provide power to this circuit, we are using this DC regulated power supply. Okay, so as per our circuit diagram, what voltage we are using over here? 10 volt we are using as a supply voltage. So here you can see that I have already set that voltage to 10 volt. Let us start the connections. So first of all, turn off the power supply. First you have to set the desired voltage and then connect the power supply in the circuit. So here I have connected positive and negative. Okay, second supply we are not using. Okay, so what I will do, I will short these two terminals. So these two terminals are shorted. It means what? Second voltage is not applied. Okay, then we have to measure three currents, but we are having single ammeter. So one by one we will measure the currents. So first of all, suppose I am measuring I1. So at that time I2 and I3 are not needed. So I will connect short circuit over here. Okay, I have selected milliampere range over here. Red probe is connected in milliampere, black probe is connected in common, and here we have selected DC. So this ammeter can be used for measurement of I1. So what I will do, positive I will connect over here and negative is connected over here, positive and negative. So here what we will get? I1. Now your experimental setup is ready. Just turn on the power supply and observe this reading. Okay, so as soon as I turn on the power supply, what value you are getting? 5.01 milliampere. So this is nothing but your I1. So we have noted I1. Now we will note down I2. So what I will do, I will turn off the power supply. I will remove this short circuit. I will connect the ammeter over here so that I will get I2. Now this is replaced by short circuit. Okay, and again turn on the power supply. What value of current you are getting? 2.39 milliampere. So this is nothing but your I2. So we have noted this I2 value. Now what I will do, I will again turn on the power supply, and now we want to measure I3. So I will connect the ammeter over here and I will replace this I2 with short circuit. Okay, and again I will turn on the power supply. Okay, so as soon as I turn on the power supply, what reading I am getting? 2.62 milliampere. So this is nothing but your I3. So we will note down this value, 2.62 milliampere. So here you can see that we have noted all three currents values. Okay, now according to the KCL, incoming current, what is incoming current? I1, almost 5 milliampere. And what are outgoing currents? I2 and I3. So if we add these two currents, their addition should be equal to I1, because I1 is equal to I2 plus I3 according to KCL. So if this thing is verified, then we can say that our Kirchhoff's current law is verified. So your I2 is 2.39, I3 is 2.62. If we add them, what we are getting? 5.01. Okay. So what is your right hand side? So if you look at this, what is your right hand side? 5.01. And what is your left hand side? I1 means again 5.01. So left side is equal to right side. So these two are same. Hence our Kirchhoff's current law is verified practically. Okay, means incoming current is equal to sum of outgoing currents. Same law can be verified theoretically. Okay, so for that purpose we will do the calculations in the next part. Okay. So friends, demonstration part is already over. Now we will calculate the value of I1, I2 and I3. Okay, theoretically. For that purpose we have to apply KCL at this node. Okay, so what you can see over here, incoming current is I1, outgoing currents are I2 and I3. So as per our statement, incoming current should be equal to outgoing current. Okay, so if you apply this theorem, we are getting this equation. So if this equation is satisfied, we can say that our KCL is verified. Okay, what you can observe over here, current I1 is coming. Okay, and it is getting divided into two parts in between R2 and R3. So we have to apply current divider rule over here. So by current divider rule, we can calculate I2 as well as I3. So suppose we want to calculate I3. Now I3 is flowing through R3. So what is the opposite resistance? R2. So I3 will be equal to what? R2 upon R2 plus R3. Okay. Multiplied by total current. Now what is the total current, incoming current? I1. Okay. So now we do not know the value of I1. So first of all, we will calculate I1. So what is the I1 you are getting? It is equal to what? Total voltage upon total resistance. What is the total voltage you are applying over here? 10 volt. Okay, and what is the total resistance over here? So if you look at this, your R1 resistance is in series with parallel combination of R2 and R3. So this is the total resistance we are getting, R1 plus R2 parallel to R3. Okay, now put these values and calculate this total current. Okay, so this equation you are getting. Now calculate the value of IT. So here you will get 4.97 milliampere. Okay, now put this value in above equation, you will get the value of I3. So when we put R2 and R3 and total current, we are getting this equation. Okay, so now calculate the value of I3. So you will get 2.60 milliampere. Okay, so this is the value of I3 you are getting after calculations. Okay, so note down this value. So 2.60 milliampere we are getting. Okay, now we know what is your total current. So your total current is nothing but what? I1. Okay, because here what we have written, the current which is coming from the supply is nothing but what? Your total current. So IT and I1 are same. So I1 we have already calculated. So I1 is nothing but what? IT. So what we are getting over here? 4.97 milliampere you are getting. Okay, now what is remaining? I2. So okay, so what is the equation you are having? We are having this equation from KCL. Okay, so I1 is your incoming current, it should be equal to outgoing current, means I2 plus I3. Okay, so I1 and I3 are known to us, so this equation will give you what? I2. So what is I2? So put the values of both currents. So calculate this. So friends, if you calculate this, you will get I2 is equal to 2.37 milliampere. So note down this value over here, 2.37 milliampere. Okay, so this is about our calculation part. Now compare your calculated values with your observation table. Your I1 practically was 5.01. Here we are getting 4.97, means almost similar I1 we are getting. Then here I2 was 2.39, here we are getting 2.37. Here your I3 was 2.62 experimentally, and theoretically it is 2.60 milliampere. Okay, so if you compare both experimental and theoretical results, you will find out that almost same values we are getting. And now as per the KCL equation, your I1 should be equal to I2 plus I3. Okay, so if you put the values of I2 and I3 in this equation, so what you are getting? So if you add this, what you are getting? 4.97 milliampere. Okay, so we can say that when we add these two currents, we are getting
I1. Okay, so this verifies our Kirchhoff's current law. Okay, so in this way you can apply KCL at any node to calculate current flowing through multiple branches of any network. Okay, so thank you very much for watching this video. If you are having any doubts, difficulties and recommendations, please let me know in the comment section. So thank you very much for watching this. Have a nice day. Thank you.